Welcome to the Product Design Show. I'm Vince Penman. For the past 3.6 billion years, nature has been solving many of the same problems that designers face today.
In today's episode, we'll look at some examples of biology-inspired design. I'm Allison Tupperwine.
Designing biologically inspired components into man-made products is called biomimicry.
Some of the world's most famous inventors have used it in their designs. Take, for instance, Leonardo da Vinci.
The quintessential Renaissance man wasn't only an incredible engineer, he was also a keen observer. Throughout his notebooks are numerous observations about birds and their flight, culminating in his sketches for flying machines.
Although da Vinci never made a heavier-than-air flyer, when the Wright brothers first flew in Kitty Hawk, they too said they were inspired by their observations of pigeons.
And while flight may have been biomimetics' crowning achievements, the practice has inspired the design of a wide range of products, from Velcro to cars.
Back in 2005, Daimler Chrysler unveiled their bionic car concept, a vehicle inspired by both the shape of a yellow boxfish and growth patterns of bone.
You see, while the yellow boxfish is an odd-looking critter, its body shape actually makes it cut through the water with minimal drag. So Chrysler's designers borrowed it.
But to really make a revolutionary vehicle, the bionic car's designers looked to natural bone to dictate the way the car's frame was structured.
Bone is pretty tough stuff, but it's not totally solid. Bone actually grows to directly meet the tensile load that it will bear, so it's no heavier than it has to be.
Applying this concept to the bionic car's frame reduced the vehicle's weight while also making it stronger in just the right places.
In the end, using biomimicry helped the bionic car achieve a 70 mph fuel economy while also scooting from 0 to 60 in 8 seconds, all on a 140-horsepower engine.
Now, the bionic car is pretty cool, but nature doesn't just exist on the macro scale. Most of the time, it's so small you have to view it through a microscope.
So now designers are looking to bacteria and viruses to help design products on the nanoscale.
One massive discovery that has the potential to revolutionize entire fields and products are carbon nanotubes.
Inspired by naturally occurring carbon structures, manufactured carbon nanotubes are some of the strongest materials known to man.
Scientists have discovered that carbon nanotubes are extremely hard and good thermal conductors, and that they may have superconducting properties, making them a pretty versatile material.
With biomimetics leading designers to create even more complex products, robust design tools and huge processing power will be key to effective product development.
This episode is sponsored by PTC. To learn more about PTC Creo and how it can help your team develop complex products, visit ptc.com/product/Creo.
And thanks for watching this episode of the Product Design Show. Please give it a like on Facebook, subscribe on YouTube, or give us a rating on iTunes.